Hello everyone and welcome to NagGraphics. We have started discussing the chapter of transforming objects, and in the first part we discussed the first type of transforming, which was moving the objects. And in this video we will discuss about rotating the objects. As the name suggests, it simply rotates the selected object. Let's check out the different related options and see what exciting we can do with it. First of all, select the object you want to rotate. Then select the Rotate tool from the Tools panel. As you will select this tool, you will see a mark right in the center of the selected shape. This mark will act as an access point around which the selected shape will rotate. Like here, I am dragging my mouse to rotate, and notice that this shape is rotating around this access point. You can change the access point by simply clicking anywhere like this, and notice now this point has become the access point around which the shape is rotating. For precise rotating, by entering values in the dialog box, you can double click on this tool. Here you can enter the desired number of degrees to rotate the selected object. This copy button will make a duplicate copy with respect to the values entered by you, preserving the original shape. There is one thing to notice, that when you double click on this tool, the axis point will automatically come at the center of the shape. Like here, I mark this point to be the axis point. And as I double click here to open its dialog box, the axis will come to the center of the shape. But if you want to open the dialog box at desired axis point, press Alt key and then click anywhere, and now the axis point will be the point of click only. You can also rotate the selected object by going here and entering the desired degrees. The axis point will be set according to the reference point you choose from here. Rotating from here is a very limited way of rotating, because you only have these 9 reference points to mark your axis point. Therefore, rotating from this tool serves the purpose better. Let me show you a small practical. Here I have drawn a leaf-like design. I'm drawing a constrained circle now. I select this leaf and bring it to here. Now I will select the Rotate tool and click here with my Alt key pressed in the center of this circle to make this point the axis point of the leaf. Over here, I'll enter, let's say, 72 degrees and press Copy. So what it has done is pretty much clear that it has rotated the copy of this leaf by 72 degrees, making this point as its axis. Now if I want to run that command again, I need not to follow through all the steps. All I will do is press Ctrl D, which is the command of transform again, which precisely means it will run the last transformation again to the selected object. Every time I press Ctrl D, a new copy rotated by 72 degrees is created and the new object is shown selected, and hence pressing Ctrl D again automatically applies to the new copy. Here I have completed the flower with this command. So the command of transform again, that is the Ctrl D, is to be remembered. It's a very useful command. So this is all about rotating, and in the next video we will discuss about the next type of transformation, which is reflect. Thanks for watching NagGraphics, and stay tuned for more upcoming tutorials by subscribing to this channel.